Here we are, ladies and gentlemen. We're back here in Golden Pond. And today we're going to use one of my wife's special recipes. It's a recipe for pasta, but it's a sausage sauce. And I think everyone will like it.
Very easy and good. And fast.
And fast. So what the first thing we're going to do... Oh, I want to say this. Buona salute e mangia bene.
Yeah.
First thing we're going to do is we're going to take the skin off of four Italian sausage. And then we're gonna chop it up a little bit. Then we're going to put it in the fry pan.
With some chopped onion.
With four.
No?
No, I'm going to put this in on the stove. Emma, why don't you get the wooden spoon and spread that out. In the meantime, I'll start dicing an onion.
We're going to get a little of this here. So what are you doing now, Rima?
I'm dicing an onion, and I'm gonna put this in with the sausage meat and saute them together. And then we're gonna add some more veggies. We're gonna add celery and carrots. Dump this in and stir it in.
This isn't cooking very well.
Well, I'll turn it up a little bit.
Yeah, you just can't hear us. Turn it up.
Now we're going to dice up a carrot, nice and small. And I've got some that I started in the room. This is going to make an excellent base for the sauce. Now I'm going to take a celery, a stalk of celery, and do the same thing. Yes, you did.
So I gotta show you what I got, Reno. My good friend, Patricia, has a huge garden, and this is fresh garlic from her garden.
Oh, wow.
So I know you said you wanted minced garlic. I have this awesome food chopper that will mince it up for us if you want to use.
Well, why don't you
cinnamon tippy.
I brought some minced garlic with me, and if you want to do that, that's fine. We'll use yours.
That's funny. I was down here earlier, Reno, and it was like a ghost town. Nobody was here. You guys got it together really fast. What are we making today, Reno?
We're making a macaroni with a sausage sauce, something different.
Simple.
All these things go into the sauce. That's what started with the sausage.
Wow. Sauteing the sausage with onions,
celery,
and you
added
celery and carrots. So how long do you cook that for?
Until
it gets limp a little bit.
Okay. Until it gets a little soft.
I think you need a little oil in there.
A little oil. This oil here,
yeah.
Olive oil. I don't think we do. No.
Yeah, put some in.
Go ahead. All right, I'll just put a little in.
Easy, that's good.
Okay. All right, well, I was working on that. I would love to cut up this beautiful garlic that we got from my friend's garden.
All right.
So I'm just gonna open up the garlic. It's different when it's fresh.
All I want is about two big cloves.
Two big cloves? All right, Reno. I can do that. I mean, this came right out of the ground. There's actually a little bit of dirt on it. So I'm just going to peel it. So is that, that's two cloves.
That should be just about right.
All right, so I'm just going to cut the end off. Peel it. Oh, that smells good. When it's fresh out of, and it's not soft, it's actually kind of firm. So my friend had so much garlic, she actually had a big tub full of it. She's like, take as much as you like. I'm like, okay. So first I crush it like that, and then with the French knife, French knife rocks, so you can just rock it back and forth until it's minced.
You said you were using the minced garlic, so I didn't take it.
Probably don't even have to use as much as you would normally use it if you
want.
If you used it from, you know, these little jars, we get it, it's already minced. Did I do that too fast? So you can buy it minced, or you can mince it yourself. I have this other little thing, it's a food chopper from the Pampered Chef. And you can put it in there and it just chops it all up and you don't even have to do this. But if you know how to use a knife, I mean a French knife just kind of rocks back and forth. Move it around until it's minced. And that's how you mince garlic.
Yeah. This is coming along good. I'm mashing it to get all the flavor out of the pieces of sausage and mix it all with everything. And it's coming just good. Because this is a quick and easy recipe and we're short on time, we bought contadina tomato sauce, and we bought some collagen chicken broth, and we will be using them both.
Oh, yeah.
Here we go.
Modern conveniences.
Yeah.
They don't work.
So much for the tough can opener.
Yeah.
I'm gonna give a measuring cup.
Right here.
Reno just wanted to do that so you could see that all these new gadgets aren't necessarily the best thing to use.
16 ounces, right?
Of the sauce.
Yeah, no. So I gotta get another one. Now I'm going to be adding some chicken broth, and it's all going in the gravy pan.
A quick, easy dish when the kids, since the kids are back to school,
right.
Everybody's busy.
Okay.
When you get home, you can make this real fast for a quick meal, and it's nutritious and delicious.
Very good, Lisa.
So now we're going to put all the garlic in the pan.
Yes, we're putting all
that. All that beautiful minced garlic is going in here.
Hang in there.
You better.
I gotta go in the communion.
Yes.
Lovely. Now you know how to mince garlic, Mike.
So once you, I'm gonna go on the other side.
So Alma, is this your favorite recipe? How did you come up with it?
I found it in the Globe.
You found it in the Globe?
I did.
Wow, there's a plug for the Globe.
I did.
Not only do they have great news, they have recipes.
Yeah. I did.
Did you do any variations to it?
I was supposed to add wine.
Where's the wine?
He didn't want to put it in.
Oh, did he drink it?
No.
Yeah, put in some parsley and thing.
And basil?
But it doesn't call for parsley and basil. There you go.
Reno likes to spice things up.
Yeah.
And Alma says no. Follow the recipe.
On the recipe, yeah. That's it, wine sauce, chicken broth, and you cook for a while.
This
make the pasta and you add the sauce and cheese and you're all done.
Wow, that's really easy.
It is easy.
So Alma, how many people will this serve?
Well, if it was a single batch, it would be a pound of macaroni, so five people.
Oh,
but if you double
it,
it's more.
Boy. I would say that a double batch would feed 12 to 15 people.
Oh, 12 anyway.
We'll find out, won't we?
Yeah. You're right.
With all the sauces simmering, I'm going to make the dressing for the garlic. I'm going to add some olive oil and where's the other big thing of olive oil?
Oh.
I need the parsley in the thing though.
It's right in front of you.
Okay. Put in a little parsley. Actually, this is basil. The parsley's coming now. And we're going to add some minced garlic. All the ingredients in now. I'll put this on the stove. This sauce is coming so good.
So Alma, tell me about the pasta we're using.
Right here.
Actually, it's mezza rigatoni.
Why do we choose that one?
Well, it's easy to pick up with a fork.
Actually,
it's just
for this kind of sauce, you want a hollow macaroni because you want the sauce to go in, not only on the outside.
Oh, okay.
So it goes in and comes out at the same time.
And it's easier to pick up with a fork.
Yes, it
and
is.
And it's easier to pick up with a fork.
True.
You're good to go.
How should I do this, Reno?
Why don't you slice it horizontally, right down the middle?
It's not going to fit on this pan. Can I cut it in half?
Well, we can cut it in half after.
Okay.
Looks so soft.
It is. It's fresh from the bakery today.
Pasta sauce.
Lovely.
Tomato
sauces.
You're welcome to come.
I will.
Yeah,
for a while.
Very good.
By the way, John is going to get in touch with you.
I got a message I need to talk to him, so I'm calling him now.
Okay.
Calling him today.
Okay, good.
I got it.
Very good.
I'll be back.
Sure.
How are you doing?
Okay.
Good.
Now, put that in the pan, see how it fits.
It's a little big.
Cut it in half then. Does it fit sideways?
Nope.
No, it don't. I'll put four in the one in the end.
If my back gets better, see, that's my big problem.
I can't actually sit there, Alma, and tell me what you need me to do.
Yeah, but I mean, that's just not fun.
It's a lot of just measuring and mixing.
I've got a lot of baking stuff.
I love baking.
Yeah, and you're good at it too. Pass the pan that's boiling.
Put that in. All of it.
See, this is nice when you sit down.
Should I add some of this one?
Yeah, all of it.
Two of them?
Yeah.
All right, Reno. Two boxes of Barilla Mezzi Rigatoni. Yum.
You don't make cannolis?
No, I don't like them.
I love them.
No. I will buy them for people, you know, but I don't care for them.
So you just brush that on there, huh, Reno?
There you go.
Oh, I love it when I come over here and you give me a job.
Of course.
Oops. Liberally brush on the oil, butter, and spice mixture. Now, sometimes when I make garlic bread, I put a little cheese on it before I put it in the oven. But that's just what I like to do. This is your garlic bread, you know. Follow your recipe. All right, so the garlic bread has been basted with this mixture of oil and herbs. And butter. Should I put it in the oven, Reno? Or should we wait?
Shall we do it?
Want to do one at a time, Reno?
No, two.
Okay.
We need something to put the bread in, right? Do you want me to help you?
No.
Good.
I think it's just about done.
Just about done?
Mm-hmm.
I will give it another minute.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The reason we put the butter on is that it helps the sauce stick to the macaroni.
Here, Reno.
What?
How about a spoon? So it helps the sauce stick to the macaroni, the butter does?
Yeah.
And how much butter did you put in there? Just a little
about
bit.
About 2 tablespoons, one in each.
So we let it melt.
Now while you're doing that, I will, have we got something for that bread?
Yes, we have a bread bowl.
Okay.
All right, should I add the sauce now, Reno, to this?
Yes.
Yes. Wow, Reno, that looks delicious. You even get your vegetables in this dish.
Alma, get the bread bowl.
It's right here.
Okay.
Should I use all of it?
Well, stop right there. I want to mix that.
Ooh.
Where's the ladle?
Right here.
Mix that well.
There you go, Reno. I'll let you mix that one, then I'll mix this one over here. So it didn't end up being a very thick sauce. It's actually kind of
yes, it's
thin.
Kind of loose. Yeah. Do the same thing there. And then I'll dump this in there.
Just very flavorful though. Well, it doesn't get much easier than that, does it? How do you say delicious in Italian?
Delicioso.
Delicioso! My daughter would love this meal. She loves pasta.
Well,
see, McKenna, we're going to bring this recipe home. You can make it for dinner for me tonight. Oh, wait, maybe next week. I don't want to have it for lunch and supper.
Excuse me. Stop. Get over here. Pull up a chair.
Take
off your gloves.
I've been in the trash. I'll come back, I promise.
Well, if you come back, it'll be gone.
I'll be back very fast.
All right, fast.
It seems like our bread bowl is always bigger than our food bowl.
Want to sprinkle
some cheese? Is it typical, Reno, to have a lot of bread with a meal for Italians?
Almost everything.
Everything?
Yeah. That's enough on that one.
So just like a spoonful? Hello, Phyllis. Have a seat. We want to feed you.
Very good. Thank you.
You're welcome. What do you think, Lou?
Isn't this delicious?
Good?
Why aren't you having any?
Good, Lou? What a great lunch.
Isn't this great?
This is great, huh, Dolores?
I know.
Do you like to cook, Dolores?
I don't cook like this. This is fantastic.
Oh, simple. Simple. And you know, if you're home, like I say, you know, we had interruptions, mm-hmm. You can make this in 10 minutes.
Yep.
10 minutes.
Oh, yes, you could.
Come Dolores on. Is like 10 minutes.
You could. You could make it in 10 minutes.
Not me.
Yeah, cut up your carrot. That's the big deal. And then you're on your own.
Oh my god.
Can you put other vegetables in there other than carrots and broccoli?
Sure.
You could put broccoli in.
Asparagus. In there there's onions, celery, and carrots.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
You said I have a little bowl.
I did.
You had a very little
bowl. I had a very little bowl.
This is delicious.
I'm watching. Thank you.
You know what I think of when I eat this?
What do you think?
I think of the snow outside and you're getting a hot meal inside, you know.
Exactly.
Just a minute, folks.
It's Diving Driving time, and we got a great Western for you today.
Diving Driving is a new program featuring the HCAM staff's favorite B-movies. We hope you enjoy these treasured films of yesteryear.
And even if we don't get paid, there ain't no job we trade. We're hauling freight from state to state along with Santa Fe.
So check out the HCAM TV website at hcam.tv for movie names and showtimes.
Welcome to Hopkinton Coffee Break.
A very special dessert done by a woman from Hopkinton that
yes.
I've started using regularly.
We had your residents participating both as vendors and as shoppers.
Yeah.
And
that was so much fun.
Real Hopkinton Housewives, if you're on Facebook, you will have a blast. Thanks for joining
us. Cheers, guys.
Us. Great...
Thank you.
Yeah, good to see you
too. See you guys.
Bye.
This show often talks to people who have interesting hobbies or careers or different things that they have going on that affect our community.
I'm Mary Arnott, your host.
There is a huge need for providing food for individuals and family.
And that's the key.
That's the key.
It's working well together.
You can see more episodes online at our website, hcam.tv.